الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمدك اللهم سبحانك كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. نحمدك اللهم آناء الليل وأطراف النهار، معترفين بسلطانك، حامدين شاكرين لنعمائك. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يديم علينا نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة، وأن يلهمنا العزم والعزيمة والصبر والثبات على أن نحمده على تلك النعمة. اللهم أمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يحيي ويميت، وهو حي لا يموت، وهو على كل شيء قدير. شهادة قامت بها السماوات والأرض. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا يحرمنا إياها لحظة لقائه. اللهم أمين. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. اللهم اجزه عنا خير ما تجزي به مرسلا ونبيا. اللهم شفعه فينا شفاعة لا نعذب بعدها أبدا. اللهم اسقنا من حوضه شربة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم أمين. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم طب القلوب ودواؤها، وعافية الأبدان وشفاؤها، ونور الأبصار وضياؤها. صلى عليك الله يا عالم الهدى، ما هبت النسائم وما ناحت على الأيك الحمائم. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our children, the future of Islam, inshaAllah رب العالمين. Few days left to welcome the month of Ramadan. Maybe 11 days, maybe 12 days, depending on the sighting of the moon for the beginning of the month of Ramadan. We're still in the month of Sha'ban, that month where, as we have seen before, the eighth month of the Hijri calendar, the lunar calendar, Rajab the seventh, Ramadan is the ninth. And I'm wondering how much of emphasis we put on the understanding of the month of Sha'ban and what happened during that month, and how significant both things happening during the month of Sha'ban 1400 years ago are really related to what we have been seeing nowadays, have been witnessing. How much we could be learning from what happened 1400 years ago during that great month of Sha'ban. As we have seen last week, few specific things, important, extremely important things took place during that month of Sha'ban 1400 years ago. On the top of those events or things happening, Tahwil al-Qibla, changing of the Qibla, the direction from Jerusalem in Al-Quds in Palestine to Mecca, the prescribing of the fasting, the month of Ramadan, as the third pillar of Islam, and prescribing Al-Zakah as the fourth pillar of Islam upon Muslims, and then preparing the Muslim community under the leadership of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be in the first major battle of Islam, the battle of Badr. What happened before that battle, during that battle, after this battle, and then what would be planned for the rest of many years to come under the leadership of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As we have seen last week, we looked at the changing of the Qibla. 16 months, Muslims have been facing the direction of the Qibla toward Jerusalem, Baytul Maqdis, in Palestine, since the prescribing of the Salah during the 12th year of the birth of Islam, during that night of Al-Isra al-Mi'raj, as a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from Allah, to us Muslims, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought down to us the Salah, the second pillar of Islam, start praying, performing the prayer for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the year 12, number 12, after receiving the revelation. Year 12, 13, and then the migration from Mecca to Al-Madina, and for 16 months, as was narrated in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith al-Bara, where the Muslims were facing that direction for 16 months or 17 months. And then the revelation came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجِهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ قِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا. I've seen turning your face toward the heavens without saying anything. The answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, reaching the direction to the Qibla, will be facing the Qibla along with the followers of Islam. The question would be, why that happened? Yet many Muslims, which is really, really unfortunate, wallahi, they would take it. It's a little piece of the history of Islam, changing the Qibla, that's it. During the month of Sha'ban, that's it. But no major effort to put into that significance of that changing of the Qibla. Now some people say, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to be done this way, that's fine. In the first place, why 16 or 17 months Muslims are facing the Qibla toward Jerusalem, Baytul Maqdis in Palestine, and then it's changing there? You would love to hear that debate. Muslims on one side, the Mushrikeen, pagans on the other side, the Yahud in Medina, Jewish people, tribes in Medina on the other side, and the Munafiqeen, the hypocrites in Medina at that time. Each and every single one of them has his own debate and his own view and his opinion, their opinion about what happened, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving of the significance of that changing, subhanallah rabbil alamin. When you think of that tahweel al-qibla, think about it as follows. Politically speaking, siyasiyan, military speaking, askariyan, religiously speaking, deeniyan, and a lot of people say all of these factors, politics on one side and military on the other side, and deen, the religion, on the third side, would be highly related to changing of the Qibla? Yes. But how many of us Muslims do have that understanding? That's the issue. Because today when we're talking about the changing of the Qibla related to what is going on today, as if we're speaking, you'll be surprised, wallahi. You'll be wondering, subhanallah rabbil alamin. Because here we're talking about Jerusalem, Al-Quds, in Palestine, where Palestine is occupied by the Zionists. And Mecca, in Arabian Peninsula, and we know what is happening nowadays in Arabian Peninsula. We know what's going on, subhanallah. Till the point, يعني, some Muslims are saying, يعني, Mecca would be safe, would be secure, and that sacred house will be safe and secure, given what is going on today as if we're speaking. What are the enemies of Islam planning for that sacred house today and many years to come? And in Medina of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the Arabian Peninsula, or they changed its name to go after their monarchy, kind of. We should understand what is going on, ikhwah Allah, in terms of changing the Qibla at that time, subhanallah. And when you think about how that changing of the Qibla has many dimensions, When you come to politics in here to tell us that Arabian Peninsula, since that time, became the center of the whole universe, politically speaking. We're not talking about religion yet. We're not talking about the history yet. It is. Why? Islam. Birth of lives of Islam. Where? Mecca. Where? Arabian Peninsula. But what is the status of Islam nowadays as if we're speaking? How is it? How is Islam? Islam bikhayr. Islam is good. Wallahi. But it is Muslims. What is going on to 1.7 billion Muslims today who are adhered to Islam, who are believing in Islam, who are following Islam? Where are they? What they are doing? How much of effort and energy they are putting for their own people, their country, their nation to be developed? You know the answer, Allah. Maybe much better than I do. Can we go a country by country to see what's going on? Know what is going on. If you don't care that much about some other Muslim countries, think of your own. Think of your own, what is going on in your own country, Islamically speaking. What's happening? Put Islam aside, economically speaking. Put economy aside, politically speaking. Developmentally speaking. How are we doing? Are we taking that issue of changing the Qibla now? Mecca, Arabian Peninsula, the center of the whole world, like it or not. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained upon us Muslims. Yeah, and some people say, that's because, you know, we have to fulfill that fifth pillar of Islam, Hajj. So we'll go there, you know, to Al-Kaaba and then Sacred House and Mecca and Medina. No. Ikhwa. It goes beyond that. We must take the lead. We must be number one. Islam has to prevail. Muslims have to be developed. That's the issue. Changing the Qibla at that time, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, along with the Sahaba, were in Medina. What was the status of Mecca at that time? Who had the upper hand in Mecca? Who was controlling Mecca? Who was even controlling the sacred house there? And arranging the trips coming from everywhere? Who did have the upper hand? The mushrikeen, the pagans, al-kuffar, there in Mecca at that time. That's why you Muslims, salah has been prescribed on you on Laylatul Isra al Mi'raj. Not yet the direction to Mecca. Jerusalem first. In order to think of Palestine and al-Quds and think of Ibrahim and Ismail and Musa and Isa. So by changing the Qibla, you do not forget about them. No. They are still in the heart of the matter for Muslims. But again, as I said last week, you have to look at that triangle, that connectedness, that beautiful relationship. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Mecca to Jerusalem in Laylatul Isra wal Mi'raj in Palestine. From there to the heavens, the seventh and beyond. And from there, coming back to where, Ya Rasulullah? Some Muslims even arguing, come back to Al-Madina. Or come back to somewhere else. But come back to Mecca. See that triangle? Mecca. Jerusalem, Palestine. The heavens, Allah. And from Allah back to Mecca. And from Mecca to Palestine. And Palestine to Allah. And anything in between, anything around. I'm afraid Muslims are saying, who cares? I need my own country to be developed. I need my own even town. My village, I was born and raised up there, to be good. So when I visit my relatives, my friends, or my family members, extended family, they are good. They have fresh water to drink, and a good food to eat, and a good way of road, when we're driving, or a good road when we're driving. Or even to reduce it little by little, it's myself, and that's it. And I don't care about anyone else. It's really unfortunate what's going on nowadays among Muslims. I don't care. I don't care anymore. What can we do? No, we have a lot to do. As Allah taught us, and as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. For Muhammad, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجِهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَوَلِّيَلَّكَ قِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا فَوَلِّ وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ وأينما كنتم فولوا وجوهكم شطرا. Wherever we are, this is our direction. Whenever we're praying, this is our direction. Whatever we do, this is the place we have to face. This is the birthplace of Islam. This is we have to defend. This is we have to pay our life with any price ever to protect it. Meaning to protect Islam. Meaning to be the best people ever. That's why. But not to take it as a change in the Qibla. And oh yeah, Sha'ban. And Laylatul Nisf min Sha'ban. Let's pray, let's fast, let's do this. And forget about the main issue of the month of Sha'ban. Changing the Qibla. Changing the Qibla at that time. Politically, we have to be the center of the whole world, wallahi. Historically, this is what's happening, this is what's going on. Religiously, Islam. Nothing else. It doesn't mean we ignore Christianity, as I said last week, or Judaism. No, they are the Abrahamic faith. We have to connect, we have to relate, no doubt about it. What did Muslim say and do after the change of the Qibla? Now, what did the Jewish tribe do and say? Now, what did the Munafiqeen did and say? What are the pagans said and did? Subhanallah Rabbil Alamin. For Muslims, and look here at the beauty of al-aqidah, the belief, the trust, the good relationship, subhanallah rabbil alameen. Wallahi, think about it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is performing salatul dhuhr there, subhanallah. In Masjid Bani Salama, facing the Qibla to Jerusalem. And the Sahaba lining up behind him to perform the salah, following exactly what he's doing. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen. The wahi, when it came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, تَوَلِّ وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. Change the direction during the salah. Not while they were eating or having fun or having a meeting or waiting for the wahi to come. No, during the salah. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam changed the direction, what the Sahaba did behind him, change the direction. No single one would have said, what is going on in here, Muhammad? We're facing here, or why he's facing here? No one questioning, no one disobeying, no one saying, what is happening, what's going on? Did he do a mistake? Did he lost his mind? Did he do such and such? No. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. An-Nabi wal Rasul wal Mustafa wal Mubta'ath wal Shafi'u Muhammad. Direction this way, we'll follow. Direction the other way, we'll follow. That's it. No indication whatsoever. No even introduction to what would happen. Nothing he told them before. It is the aqeedah, the belief in Allah and in Rasulullah. Whatever he said, I follow. Whatever he did, I follow. Whatever he taught me, I follow. Where are we from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam today? Think it here. Think. Later he would explain to us. Later he would tell us what is happening. Later he would share with us what's going on. And he's not doing something in his own, but from the wahi. It would teach us something today. Where are we Muslim from the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam today? Where are we? Though we have the teaching available to us in all languages, no excuse. Everything has been translated, no excuse. All the ulama are teaching, no excuse. All the imams are teaching the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no excuse. I can read, I can find out. Yet, at that time, look now at the aqeedah. Look at the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not questioning, not wondering. Change, that's it. Without uttering any word. Two rak'at toward Jerusalem, two other rak'at toward Mecca. That's it. Think about your aqeedah, Allahi. Think about your relationship with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when it comes to a situation like that. I'm sure nowadays, you know, if he's among us today and he does what he did, you'll find many people finally, Subhanallah! Oh, you did a mistake. Correct your mistake. Subhanallah, another one, if he did not correct his mistake. A third, Subhanallah! Till the whole masjid will go, Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Muhammad, you did a mistake. As we do today, yani, if the imam did something wrong, most knowledgeable person behind him would say, "Ya imam, yani, Subhanallah." And imam would say, "Oh, it's not the right thing to do, or the right rak'ah to perform." Or, but the Sahaba said nothing. Look at the education. Look how they were aware of the leader. To follow. Where are our leaders today to learn from you, Muhammad? Where are you? What you're teaching us? What kind of leadership you do have? What elements and qualifications our leaders do have in order to lead Muslim Ummah today? You know the qualification they do have today? You know it. If you don't, I'm going to say it to you. Money. If I have the money, I can redirect the whole dimensions of the whole world. You know what I mean by money, right? You know how much they are paying, right? In not in thousand, wallahi. Not wallahi in million, but in billions. And it's not going to Muslims, no. And to non-Muslims, to the enemies of Islam. Muslims' money are in the hands of the so-called leadership of Muslims, but it goes to non-Muslims to be used to fight Muslims. Isn't that what is going on? If I'm mistaken, Allah, tell me, no. No, you're saying something wrong. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a leader. Remember him. Follow him. Think of that direction, subhanAllah. Think of that changing, subhanAllah, Rabbil Alam. For Muslims, they would say, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا وَغْفُرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرِ. Anything coming from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we heard it, we understand it, we comprehend it, and absolutely we're obeying. Whatever you're telling us. Glory to you, Allah. Glory to you, Allah. Muhammad, we listen to as a leader. And Allah, glory to you. You are the leaders of the leaders of the leaders. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sami'na wa ata'na. Amanna bihi kullum min indi rabbina. We believe in it. Everything is coming from Allah to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We follow. Are we saying the same or doing the same? Following the same? Ask yourself. You are the one who would have the answer. سمعنا وأطعنا آمنا به كل من عند ربنا. طب what the المشركين said or did, the pagans in Mecca, the disbelievers at that time. خالف قبلة الأنبياء. قبلة الأنبياء here. إبراهيم عليه السلام there. All the prophets and messengers there. Now Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم changed his mind, changed the direction, ignore all the prophets and messengers did, because they knew that that was built by Sayyidina Ibrahim عليه السلام and his son Ismail عليه السلام. Now Muhammad is ignoring all of these and he went to Jerusalem Al-Quds. He in a disagreement with all the prophets and messengers. Idiots! Ignorant! Do not know the essence and the wisdom behind it. We do, as it is stated in the Quran. This is the mushrikeen. Of course, you know, they have to say something. You know, they have to have some input. They have to create that atmosphere of doubtness and an atmosphere of don't believe in him, he's doing something wrong. He's not truthful, you know, he's not telling you the truth. No. Al-Mushrikeen. لو كان نبيا لصلى إلى قبلة. He's not a prophet. We're telling you, but you did not listen to us. If he's a true prophet, he would face that one as the prophets, other prophets. Did. The Jewish people, Jewish tribe in Al-Madinah, what did they say? Well, each one has to say something. Each one has to contribute and have their opinions and their saying and their... Subhanallah. إن كانت الأولى حقا فقد تركها. يعني he's claiming that مكة الكعبة is the truth. Why did he leave it and face Jerusalem? So it means it wasn't that with the truthfulness. But now leaving Al-Quds direction after he had that direction going back there. So how much of confusion we do have. That's why it is stated in the Quran, Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen, سَيَقُولُ السُّفَهَاءُ مِنَ النَّاسِ مَا وَلَّاهُمْ عَنْ قِبْلَتِهِمْ الَّتِي كَانُوا عَلَيْهَا قُلْ لِلَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبِ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَى صُرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. سَيَقُولُ السُّفَهَاءُ. Quran in here is prescribing the Jewish people, those tribes at that time in Al-Madinah with السُّفَهَاءُ. سَفِيهُ fool people. With a lot of foolishness. They would consider themselves the most smartest people ever. As-sufaha'u. As-sufaha'u at that time. Sayaqulu as-sufaha'u. Why they change, you know, the direction? It's not your business. Are you following that direction? In the first place to ask. If you're following that direction along with Muslim, you may have a say to question why they change. But you're not following in the first place. Why stick your nose such a thing? Like what they do nowadays. In everything. They have a say. They have influence. That's the way. Like it or not, this is what's happening. يَقُولُ السُّفَاءُ مَا وَلَّهُمْ عَنْ قِبْلَتِهُمْ الَّتِي كَانُوا عَلَيَّ. What's the answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? قُلْ لِلَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبِ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَى صُرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. If it is east, if it is west, all belongs to Allah. Allah directs whomsoever to that direction. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in control, not you, not us, not anyone else. خلاص انتهت، محسومة القضية. It's determined already by Allah سبحانه وتعالى. That's you know the way. تبقى المنافقون، the hypocrites. They were there, and they are here today. They also they have to have a say about what is going on, what's happening. All of this just to create that confusion, that mistrust in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Put a lot of questions about the leadership of him sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Denigrate the followers, say he's doing something, you believe in him, but look at him, you know, he's just you know leading you like a bunch of sheep. Right, left, up, down. No question, no nothing. ما يدري محمد أين يتوجه. Muhammad does not know which direction he would take. At the beginning, one direction, second, another one, third one, we do not know. This is what is going on from the Yahud in Medina, the Mushrikeen, the people, المنافقين there. What was the test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Muslims at that time? What was the mihna? What was the ibtila? How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tested Muslim community at that time with that changing of the qibla. That's what we'll see inshaAllah. Lazilna fi rahab al-Mustafa. Al-birru la yabla. Wal-dhambu la yunsa. Wal-dayyanu la yamun. Kullu bin adam khatta. Wa khayru al-khatta'in al-tawwabun. Wal-ta'iun al-dhambi kaman la dhambala. Idu'u Allah wa antum muqinuna bil-ijaba. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our sons and daughters, the future of Islam, إن شاء الله رب العالمين. What's really hurting me the most personally, wallahi, and making me questioning and wondering and trying to understand our Muslim fellows, our brothers and sisters in Islam, and our community, and our acts of worship, our relationship to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I find out that every year when we're experiencing the month of Sha'ban, majority of Muslims are emphasizing